Argyrotype is an alternative photographic process similar to the Van Dyke process. It was invented in 1991 by Mike Ware. It uses silver and iron salts to create sepia-toned photographs. The images produced are durable and resist aging well, making it a popular choice for photographic artworks. Argyrotype uses a chemical solution of ferric iron and silver sulfonate applied to paper. Let's see how to make it. In a previous video, we saw how to make silver nitrate from an ancient coin. So let's start by looking at how to make silver sulfonate from our own silver nitrate. First, we'll make silver oxide, which we'll then convert into silver sulfonate. Weigh out around 11 grams of silver nitrate and place it in a beaker. You can dissolve it in distilled water, but here we just have the crystals. Next, we prepare a solution containing about 3 grams of sodium hydroxide, the quantity of water being of little importance. Carefully pour the sodium hydroxide into the nitrate, and you'll see a dark brown precipitate form. This is silver oxide, Ag2O. We'll try to recover this precipitate. To do this, we'll need to filter and rinse it several times to obtain as pure a solid as possible. Rinse it with distilled water to remove impurities. Here's the silver oxide we got. It can be drained or even dried to preserve it. But for the next step, we'll collect it with a spatula and place it in a beaker. Now we proceed to the preparation of silver sulfonate. We'll prepare a solution of about 8 grams of sulfonic acid in about 80 milliliters of water. This is a mineral acid found in some descalers and is fairly easy to obtain. We place our oxide in a large beaker on a hot stirrer and pour in the sulfonic acid. The reaction isn't quite immediate, but the brown solid will eventually dissolve. Silver sulfonate is formed and is fairly soluble. A few brown traces remain and we'll filter them out, although this isn't essential at this stage. Prepare 24 grams of ammonium iron 3 citrate. This is a green powder. We'll now limit exposure to light using either an incandescent lamp or a red light. Pour it into the silver sulfonate solution. If necessary, add 20 to 30 milliliters of water to the solution. Shake to obtain a clear solution. If it's not perfectly clear, it's not a problem, as the solution is now filtered. The result is a clear dark green solution that appears yellow when spread on paper. I add a few drops of 20 surfactant, but this is optional. You can also top up the liquid level with distilled water to obtain a final volume of 120 to 130 milliliters, given the quantities of product we've used. This solution can be spread on watercolor paper, then exposed for a few minutes to UV light with a negative. The solution must be stored in a plastic container that is completely opaque to light. It can be kept for several years, but may sometimes need to be refiltered. The solution can then be applied to paper and exposed to light with a negative, a subject we'll cover in a future video.